Welcome to September. Here's your psychic tarot reading for the month. This month, this is what we will go over. We will cover your current self, the month's theme, you at the beginning, middle, and end of the month, the key goal to achieve, how to do it, obstacles to overcome, how to do it, good news, what to avoid, your spirituality modality of focus this month to help you get through it. And then I wanted to let you know that when I polled people on Instagram and on Facebook, they all said what they really wanted to focus on this month was money and career. So I will be putting that in a separate set of videos for you this month to this YouTube channel, and hit the little bell notification so that when those come out, you are immediately aware and alerted in case you like these. I would also appreciate it if you would share these videos with people that you think would find helpful, because otherwise how are they going to find them, right? And here's something new that we're doing this month. If you are to go ahead and share this video on Facebook or Instagram, please go ahead and tag me, because this month I'm giving away a zodiac sign necklace, which obviously it would be the one. If you're a Pisces, that'd be the one that you want to share, right? In this picture, this is an example of the different Pisces necklaces that would be going out, but I have them for every single sign. Those would be shipped out halfway through the month, so make sure that you tag me in it. Because if you don't, I can't see the post, and then I can't DM you for your shipping address. So I'll be giving away one for each one of these signs. Let's get started. Hi, Aries. Welcome to September. If this is your first time showing up to watch this video, thanks for tuning in. This is for Aries Sun, Moon, or Rising. You'll want to watch the career video if it for your rising sign, just because that's what that's for. For matters concerning the heart, that would be your moon sign. Just generally though, this would be the best fit for your sun sign, okay? So the current self this month, Aries, what I have is that you're making the best out of every situation, even if it's kind of shitty, okay? And I'm not saying that you're going to have a shitty month, but you're being particularly optimistic. You're in a better mindset this month, which is good news. As far as your month's current theme, it's all about patience. And this is correlating to all of the different chakras. So you're patient with like actual physical tangible things, with others, with your own self, with your thought processes, your feelings, and you're able to let the universal energy of transformation move according to its own loving rhythm. So allowing yourself to kind of go with the flow, not pushing too hard, just sitting back, watching how everything kind of falls into place, and that's actually super working to your benefit, okay? So if you're struggling with that, that's something that you fully want to embrace. Understanding that everything happens for a reason. Even if it doesn't feel good, it's often for our highest good, right? So at the beginning of the month, you might not be feeling super amazing. You might be feeling particularly emotionally imbalanced, but this is because it's for your highest good, right? You're healing from something. You're processing something. You're moving on. In the middle of the month, now this is where you get your mojo back. This is where you're feeling super confident. You're back to your Aries self. You're kind of standing out in the crowd. It's all wonderful that way. And then at the end of the month, this is where whatever hadn't fallen off in the beginning of the month, whatever you hadn't fully processed, you might encounter a little bit of, again, change, disharmony, discord, a little bit of drama in your life, but not in a bad way. It's like certain things and people are going to drift out in order to allow us to build up or replace that space, that energy, with something new and better for us, okay? So the key goal to overachieve this month is just kind of forcing yourself to follow through with new ideas that you have and to do it with enthusiasm. And the way that you do that is to take this energy when you're feeling a little bit down or hopeless and go, you know what, actually, let me try to do something about this. If you're not familiar with Mel Robbins, her 5-4-3-2-1 strategy would be very helpful for you. So you could look that up on YouTube. Obstacles that you'll be wanting to overcome or needing to overcome is the way that you're thinking about the past, okay? So it's not like you're looking back on the past
and going, oh man, that really sucked and this is making me feel depressed. It's more like you're looking back on the good times in the past and then feeling sad or like regret in regards to like how maybe you contributed to fucking up a good relationship or, you know, I wish I would have taken that opportunity that I didn't, and beating yourself up a little bit. And this isn't, it's funny because you usually don't have anything in common with Virgo readings, but Virgos have the capacity to do that this month as well. So I wonder if that's something astrologically that might be going on. So if you're tuned into the astrological world, let me know in the comments if that's something that you've seen as predicted with the universal energies kind of that'll be affecting all of us. So how is it that you overcome that energy? And they go, well, a lot of you might kind of just decide to stay trapped in it, unfortunately, because it's a pattern. And it's what you're used to. Even if the pattern's uncomfortable because it's familiar, we often choose to stay there. And so you'll have to try to really force yourself to see things through a different lens. So it's completely on you and your thought patterns and your mindset. Good news for you this month is that, you know, even though there are people around you who are ready and able and willing to help you with things, you're kind of like, okay, I can do this on my own. And you totally can, especially in the middle of the month. What you should be avoiding this month is this fear that history repeats itself. So for some of you, probably those of you not watching this video, that absolutely will be the case because you won't shift mindset. You'll be stuck in that pattern of behavior and you're going to say, you know what, like, because this is the way that things have always been, this is the way they're going to keep going. But if you're one of those, especially in the beginning of the month, who says, you know what, actually, I have the power to change this. Just because this is the way things usually go doesn't mean that it has to be the way that things go in the future. And then kind of owning your own side of that and taking the steps to change whatever it is in your life that you don't like. You know, that reminds me of a flowchart that I had made for a client. I think for the most part, it's sort of plagiarized. I think I saw something very similar somewhere. I'm gonna try to add this to the video maybe right there if I can figure that out on my laptop. But if not, I apologize, I'm sorry. But you know, ultimately, if you don't like the way that things are going, it is on you to change it. So, the spirituality modality of focus that's of most benefit to you this month, and there's talking about law of attraction. So whatever it is we think about, it expands, right? Whatever we think about, we bring about. So we don't want to be thinking about the things we don't want. We don't want to be thinking about the things we regret, because then we're only attracting into our life more of what we don't want and more regrettable situations. If we are thinking about this is what I do want, then we're going to draw that in. So that's an area that you could actually make a change for the better in your own life and start taking control and achieving the things that you desire. So money and career will be in a separate video, and I'm going to put that at the end if you're watching on YouTube. It'll be a clickable link, and I will see you in October. Mwah! Love you the most.
Thanks for getting all the way to the end of this video with me. Click here to sign up to win a free 20-minute video reading. Click here if you want to see the career and money video. And click here to subscribe.